Hello everybody, good evening. Woo. Another time for Moment of Hope.
Excited.
I just get so excited about Thursday. It's when I have to come your way with Moment of Hope. Because it's a time that I get to pray with you, I get to worship with you, I get to invite my friends over. This is our favorite couch for this season. You've seen more of this couch.
I love this couch.
God bless everybody who's been joining us for the four previous episodes. It's been God. That's what I can say. It's not been man. It's just been God doing his own thing through us. And we thank God. We humble ourselves for these anointing. I mean, who are we that he keeps blessing us every time? Who am I that he keeps giving me this opportunity to be able to sit down with amazing friends who come to bless my own life and be a blessing to people on Facebook? I see the messages and I see all the comments coming through. To God be the glory. And whatever that you are expecting, tonight is no difference. Tonight is no difference. I'm telling you that you are going to experience God in his wildest glory, in his amazing stuff that he's going to do. Things are going to be moving a little faster with prayer and word and songs, of course. So join us, pray with us, pray along, and you'll be blessed. The man I have here is... So I know this man for a very long time. I've been a friend of his for 2 years, I think. Two years. And 2 years from afar. Why? Because Facebook is a global village. I tell you, use Facebook well. Facebook is a blessed platform. If you want it to be a blessed platform for you. I met him on Facebook. I met him on Overflow videos. I met him on Marjorie. It was fantastic, man. So when he starts singing, and I'm like, oh my goodness, I want to meet this guy. I want him to be my friend. And here we are. JAPHET is here, everybody. He's called JAPHET. So tonight he's gonna lead us in worship. Don't get bored. Don't get too like that. Yes. That's for your welcome.
Thank you, man. I'm blessed.
Yeah.
I've been looking for it. I've been watching the
video.
I'm blessed.
Is that you watching the videos?
Yeah, okay. I'm shy.
Because you're too big, like you're huge guy.
I'm so excited.
Okay guys, in the presence of God we are all children before him. So call your friends. Let's just enter in and worship.
Let's I want to bless the name of God.
Yes,
everywhere you are, yes, in our worship.
Yes,
I want to be here to bless the name of God.
Yes,
it's been wonderful.
So, your name, God bless you.
It's been our arm.
Thank you, oh God. Thank you,
our strength.
Thank you,
oh God. Everything.
Thank you, oh God. Thank you, oh God.
It's been the one.
We bless your name, oh God.
We must bless your chances.
We bless you, oh God.
And Father, that we bless you upon our lives. I have eight other siblings.
Yeah.
And I'm the last one
okay.
of nine.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's more like a football team. Plus my mom. Yeah, 11. And I can't believe I'm here today. Like, when I look at myself, I'm like, way back, I don't think I would have been here. Like, if anybody told me, oh, or even have the opportunity to even wear a shoe like this or wear shirts like this, I mean, because as many as we were, we lived in a single room. My mom, my dad, my siblings, everybody in one single room. So you can imagine how we pack ourselves in a room. God has been good. And I bless God for the family he gave me, even though there was nothing at home or anything. gave us himself. And the ministry, the music ministry was a calling that was moving around the family. And we're actually, I was ST the seventh Sunday.
Oh, wow. Just,
so we went to the Saturday church. I love it. I've been through a lot of experience. I was able to finish JHS 2007.
Wow.
And I was home for about 4 years.
Wow.
But like, it was like a setback. Wow. And there's no sibling of mine who's been to the university. And I'm the first. The last one. I'm the only one who has been to the university. How it happened, I mean, I think I saw it earlier. When I was getting to my 10, whilst I was moving, I wasn't able to go to high school and all that. My mates were going through the 10. Whilst my mates were in the university, I was now struggling to go to SS. So I.
But you said you were okay, right?
Yeah. The Holy Spirit spoke to me and had to leave home.
Wow.
I left him and I went to stay with him for a while. I told my dad, Charlie, I can't stay here because I see everybody's come after me, but that is not where you're supposed to be. So I left. And I started pursuing all the things that, I don't know how, I can't remember how God did it, but I'm here today.
This is a great testimony. So. Wow.
So I want to sing this song. It says, "You've been faithful, Lord, from the ages past. That is why your name is forever."
Wow. Wow. Wow.
"You've been faithful, Lord, from the ages past. That is why your name is forever. Who your name is? Boy, you're too full of when
you
be this scripture which says, Romans 8:18, the sufferings of the present times cannot be compared to the glory which will be
revealed. Yes. Yes.
Right now, the glory that, I mean, it's around me that I feel that God has really blessed me. When I look back, I can't compare that with. Because
too good.
He's been good. Because even sometimes I see some of my friends way back in churches. Some of them. I recently saw one who was in this rubbish collector. He was one of them. And recently also saw one doing the mate's job. And like, I could have been like them.
Too good.
I could have been like them. But God has raised me higher. Yeah, I can't thank him enough. And I know there are other people also going through this struggle.
Yes, God.
And
people are going to be stuff for that.
And believe in God for them. If they can only believe, if they won't lose faith, if they will keep hoping in God for something to happen, God is going to show up.
He will.
God is going to show up.
Yeah.
I was watching, I mean, past episodes of what we've done. And one thing that struck me was sometimes we don't pray for the needy. We barely forget. We don't pray for them. And when we see them in traffic, we pass them. We don't pray for them. For me, this year, what I've said is 2018, none of my friends should be broke. If you are broke, call me. Yeah, if you don't have money, just call me. If I have you, if I don't have you, find money together. You don't have to be. It's painful. You know what thing? It's painful that the minister of God is not broke. Hey, that one is painful. I'm telling you. That you wake up one day, you have no one single to even do anything. But people will see you on film like, hey, minister. Yeah, yeah. But you know the pain you go through. You need to break things. People need to have financial freedom. Christians don't have to suffer. For me, 2017, I didn't suffer. And I say it with so much peace and happiness because I knew what I sold. Without SOE, you can't reap that happiness you claim you want to have. And so I expect you that anytime you go to church and they tell you, come and sow, even if you don't have the 50 Ghana, send that one seed. God sees that money more than that 50. Maybe the person who gave the 50 has more. But if that is your last, give that to God. And He will bless you more than you can even imagine. That is what I did. That is my secret. I don't have money, but I have enough to keep me going. And so I pray with you that as you watch this video, I pray financial freedom. It's not about the shouting, but I release freedom in your finances. Things that you touch is blessed. Will not be, but is blessed. From this day forward, everything that your mouth would say would bring money in return. Things that you do with this instrument would bring you financial freedom. You will serve God real good. No more struggle in your finances. No more, give me money, give me this. Can you borrow me that? You are done with borrowing. You will lend to many. You will give to many. God is expanding your territory. Your financial freedom is here and it's for you now. In the mighty name of Jesus, He said in John chapter 14, verse 14, that if we ask anything in His name, He will do it. In the mighty name of Jesus, I release financial freedom over your life. If it's education, if it's your school, if it's school fees that you are calling for that uncle, I'm praying with you right now, the way that God made the king remember Esther. Everybody that had to show you favor, we turn their minds around in the name of Jesus. The way the king could not sleep and remember Mordecai in the midst of his sleep, that he made the guys come to read the scrolls to him till Mordecai's name came up for his glory to be shown. This minute, I release you into that glory, that anybody who is assigned to your destiny to cause you to move into your financial freedom, we release you in there in the mighty name of Jesus. It is yours, that liberty. It is yours in the name of Jesus. Claim it, it is yours.
In some families, there's money.
Yeah.
For the use of the money, you have money, but you don't know how to use it. Before I was born, my dad was a very wealthy.
Ooh, man.
But he didn't build any house. He didn't do any investments with anybody. Yes. You know, unfortunately, my siblings couldn't go to invest in all that. It didn't mean that maybe we weren't blessed or we were poor from
scratch.
But there's a setback that is blocking all those things.
Family setbacks. You break it out. Just open your mouth. We break family setbacks. Things that you are moving for are pulling you back spiritually. The mighty name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray into your family. Any barrier that is holding your progress, we break it down in the name of Jesus. Let the name of Jesus swift through your families. Let the name of Jesus be lifted up. The name of Jesus is lighter. Wherever light is, there is freedom. Wherever freedom is, there is atmosphere of liberties, of atmospheres, of miracles. We pray that miracles will overflow you in 2018. Setbacks will be far away from you in the mighty name of Jesus. Experience this miracle. Experience this freedom. I sense freedom in this atmosphere. You have the freedom of God. Sin. This week, know that you are living like a conqueror. You have defeated the enemy. He's been defeated before you were born. You are no more in bondage. You have financial liberty. It is yours. Claim it. It is yours. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Oh, God. Hey.
Joining us, and we see you soon, okay? Next week, I'll see you. Keep praying, keep loving the Lord. Know that Jesus is having you in mind, he's carrying you all through and through, and your life will never be the same from now. You have freedom, it is yours in the mighty name of Jesus. That's it. Tell me what I said. Always a blessing. Do it again. God bless you guys. Bye.